Of the seven knobs available to steer an enterprise towards increasing profitability, innovating to create a new market or to increase the size of an existing market are often the most compelling. As Peter Drucker has been known to say, the only thing that matters is innovation. Innovation is vital to an organization because it drives productivity. It's important to note that innovation is not synonymous with invention. Invention is an input to innovation, whereas innovation itself is a manageable business process that transforms invention into a commercially useful and valuable product. Since innovation is a key driver of enterprise success, it follows that organizations are often designed to facilitate the execution of the innovation process. The design of such an organization ideally starts with the establishment of a leadership team charged with forming the new product development organization. The leadership team is responsible for crafting a strategy and making organizational design decisions consistent with that corporate strategy. One of the functions that this new product development organization must perform is to become aware of current technical advances, discoveries, or inventions that could potentially trigger the innovation subprocess. Once triggered, the innovation subprocess begins by generating concepts that transform the technical advance, invention, or discovery into a profitable product. Concepts that are likely to generate a compelling return on investment are designed, developed, and tested. The new product is then produced in large quantities. Products are marketed, distributed, and sold to generate revenue and provide an attractive profit. Execution of the product development organization process is controlled through a series of feedback loops that ideally connect to an enterprise resource planning system. Organizations recruit many supporting disciplines to help execute the functions of the new product organization process, and the process is influenced by many external forces. All of this may sound easy to some of you, but let me assure you, it is not. Even in the best of organizations, attempts at innovation often fail. The four-year success rate of new products is about 10%. Innovation often fails because there are many moving parts. Markets are moving, technologies are moving, and these movements influence one another. Furthermore, an industry analysis to assess potential profitability examines many internal and external elements, and each of these elements can be highly impacted by market and technology movements. Not easy. To help with this difficult task, senior leaders often call on systems engineers to conduct analysis and synthesize results so that they, the senior leadership team, can find system-level solutions that best balance competing objectives in the presence of uncertainty. As such, systems engineers serve as a hub and must move freely between and be conversant with leadership, technical subject matter experts, users, and other stakeholders. The systems engineer's role goes well beyond initial concept selection. Systems engineers orchestrate much of the activity across the entire innovation process. It is well documented that the product development is a process that involves hundreds of decisions. Therefore, to be most useful, decision management should be central to a systems engineer's activities. In order to get a sense for how strong decision management skills were among systems engineers, a broad examination of academic works was conducted across disciplines involved with new product development pertaining to at least one aspect of systems engineering trade-off decision practices and theories. The literature search revealed that many systems engineering publications are light on decision methods and that popular representation schemes such as house of quality, conjoint analysis, and design optimization prove useful within bounds, but have severe limitations when applied as decision methods. The literature suggests that flawed decision methods are being used within the engineering design process because they are easy to implement and the shortcomings of the methods are hidden by the complexity of the decision problem itself. Decision methods that are rooted in classical decision theory, however, avoid the catastrophic pitfalls of the flawed methods and don't need to be difficult to execute. using classical decision theory to combine and reshape elements of popular representation schemes, yields a compelling design decision method. Building a design decision method process using the format of the systems engineer's interface and responsibility as a guide leads to the understanding that a sound decision method is value-focused and fact-based. A sound decision method approaches the decision opportunity holistically, synthesizes analysis logically, and is iterative. The decision management process transforms broad statements of a decision situation into a recommended course of action and associated implementation plan for system solutions that best balance competing objectives in the presence of uncertainty. The integrated systems engineering decision management, ISDEM, process positions decision making as central to all systems engineering activity and helps ensure that systems engineering efforts are rightfully interpreted as relevant and meaningful, thus maximizing the discipline's value proposition to new product developers and their leadership. The ISDEM process is a mashup of the systems engineering discipline with the analytics discipline, combining the holistic perspective of the systems engineering with the quantitative reasoning power and data visualization tools of the rapidly growing data science field to yield decision dashboards that allow leaders to easily interact with very large data sets, build intuition, and make well-informed decisions on how to best steer their enterprise towards increasing profitability.